What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Picture this. The year is 2007. I am a senior in high school at Miami Senior High School in Miami, Florida. And I have never bowled in my entire life. And then it happened. I finally got into bowling. And today we're going to talk about that. So in front of me here, I have the Storm Surefire, which happened to come out in 2007. So I'm going to tell you the story about how I started bowling, how I got into bowling, and then we're going to throw this Surefire, which came out, like I said, the year I started bowling. So if you guys like this video, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, hit that notification bell. And if you like this jersey or any of the jerseys in any of my videos, coolweek.com, use my promo code Napoles10. 10% off your entire order. Then down below in the description, there's gonna be a link where you can order anything bowling related. There's gonna be a link to my Discord as well as my Patreon. All right, so I'm a senior in high school and I was on the basketball team, I was on the volleyball team, and we were in between seasons and my buddy Lucas was like, yo, you wanna join the bowling team in between seasons? I said, absolutely no way. I thought bowling was dumb. I thought bowling was stupid. And then he said, well, we can get you out of class early twice a week to go practice before matches. I said, I'm in. If I get to leave school early twice a week, I'm in. And then that's how everything happened. So my first year bowling, I bowled with only a house ball, house shoes. And then after I graduated high school, I wanted to get back into it a little bit. I went into the pro shop, Mike's Pro Shop in Miami, Florida. Shout out to Mike Hamilton, who's a great buddy of mine. He got me into some real bowling. Got me into my first bowling ball. And so I joined a league, a juniors league. I bowled against a really good friend of mine now, Alyssa. She whooped my tail. I think I shot like 130 to her 279. And from that moment on, I was hooked. Another really big shout out to Eric and Erika Kanoa. They're brothers, really, really good friends of mine from back home. I joined a league with them and with Mike, the guy who ran the pro shop. And ever since then, I have been absolutely hooked. So basically the whole point of this video is if you guys are just getting started in bowling or thinking about getting into bowling, I understand the frustration. I understand how hard it is, but keep at it, keep working, and we're gonna grow together. So let me know down below in the comments how you got started into bowling, what your bowling story is, and how much you love bowling today, hopefully as much as I do. And then let me know if you ever threw this Surefire. I have never thrown this ball, so let me know if you've ever had the Surefire or any ball that came out around that era, and which one was your favorite and why. I'll see you guys on the lanes here on a fresh, typical house shot. Man, I remember in 2007, I thought I had the whole world figured out. Little did I know, I didn't know anything about anything. Yeah, I don't know if this ball, maybe because it's been sitting for 15 years, but it is going straight. The biggest advice I can give any young upcoming bowler or thinking about getting started is try not to get frustrated. When things aren't going your way, just trust the process and learn. Everything's a learning experience. Guys, this ball's hilarious. I've never been able to play straight like this at Sam's Town unless it was urethane. Ooh. So, real quick, that is hilarious. Like I said, I have not been able to play this straight here at Sam's Town with anything other than like a Lane Shine urethane ball. And I don't know if this is what this ball rolled like 15 years ago, or maybe today's conditions versus then's conditions, or whatever the case may be, but I think if I was bowling here at Sam's Town, this might look pretty good, allowing me to play straight like that. I don't know. So I think the biggest thing that I want you guys to understand, like when you first get started in bowling or anything, is that the frustrations are going to be there. I've been bowling, like I said, for 15 years, and I still get frustrated when I hit the lanes. The biggest thing that I wish I could tell myself then, from what I know now, is really work with a coach, get your fundamentals down early. Don't establish any bad habits right from the jump. And that's what happened to me, and I'm still suffering the consequences. I'm gonna show you guys right now a clip of what I looked like, I don't know, 13 years ago. And if you got, you're gonna laugh, it's freaking hilarious. wow, how bad was that? I've definitely come, I think, a long way. So let's get back on the lanes, and I think I'm just gonna stay there because it's looking pretty good. I might even try to move a little bit further right, see if I can get it to pick up a little sooner. So let's get back on the lanes. All right, so like I said, I'm gonna move a little bit right here just to see. Okay, no, gotta go back to where I was. All right, so this is the same spot that I was at before. And when I get back to the desk, I'll talk to you guys about what my averages have been like ever since I started. Good shot there. Well, lucky result. That's crazy. All right, let's see if I can just get a handful at the bottom. See if I can get it to actually hook and be flush. Like that, maybe. Wow. Man, I thought that was a good shot. I'm gonna try to get the ball going a little further right into the friction sooner and see how that fares. Still super light. All right, let's try to get it right even faster now and see how this looks. Wow. All right, so that's how I got started in bowling. And then the really big jump that I made in my game was another huge shout out to William Welch. Will, if you're watching, you were so influential to what I have become. And I remember very specifically bowling this tournament called the Dade County All-Stars. I got matched up on the pair with this random guy, William Welch, early motive staffer at the time. And was like the super nice guy. I was like the very first tournament I ever bowled as an adult. And we became pretty good friends. He recommended me to this coach, Mike Nitrate. And if you're in the South Florida area, Mike Nitrate is an unbelievable coach. I got to working with him a little bit. And ever since then, things have gotten really, really good. If I was still back in Florida, I would still be taking lessons. So let's just get back on the lanes and, I don't know, maybe chase this a little bit further left. Maybe. I don't think I can. It's coming in so weak. But I am having fun throwing a bowling ball. I was going to use the word reviewing, but I'm not really reviewing this ball. Throwing a bowling ball that came out the same year that I started bowling. And just to see how far the technology has come and how different my game is from the very beginning. I forgot to talk about my averages over the years. So when I get back to the desk, I promise I'll talk about that. That's the best shot I threw today. And it hooked. All right, so let's move in a little, kind of soften up our hand, see if we can get this ball to come around the corner from a little bit further deep. There we go. Another big piece of advice, guys, is if you're gonna get started in bowling or you're still in your early stages, learn to become more versatile as a bowler. Get there. All right, let's try to be a little softer because I came through it a little too hard the last one. There we go. All right, softer hand at the bottom is what's gonna help me get to the pocket here. Got that right. All right, so now we're gonna talk about my averages since I first started bowling. And I'm just gonna go over the composite averages. So 2007, 2008 in Florida, 144. 2008, 2009, still in Florida, 144. 2009, 2010, again, still in Florida, 163. 2010, 2011, that's the year that I started working with Mike Nitrate, William Welch, all that stuff, still in Florida. I bowled a lot more. My average got up to 183. Then 2011, 2012, this was a really, really big year for me. I met this gentleman by the name of Ron Thrash, his wife Terry Thrash, Erlene, Fabian. These guys I got to bowl my first pretty competitive team with, and I had an absolute blast. This was the first year that my average started to really go up. I met the association president, Patty Nevers, who's been an unbelievable person, Glenda Beckett, all these people shaped who I am as a bowler. So that year I got to 194, which at the time was my highest average ever. Then the very next year I had a little bit of a setback. I don't really remember what the situation or what the circumstances were, but my average went down to 186. Then 2013, 2014 came. That's the year I left Florida and came here to Las Vegas. My first year here in Vegas, I averaged 204. Then in 2014, 2015, I went from 204 to 208. So that's the first year really that I was over 200. 2015, 2016, got up to 211. 2016, 2017, my standard average was 216, but I also bowled a couple sport shots leagues, but we won't talk about that. So 216, 2017, 2018, up to, or down to 214. Then 2018, 2019, we won't even talk about. That's the year I tried to go two-handed. For whatever reason, I finished that year with a 193 average. Then 2019, 2020, went back to one-handed. Average went up from 193 to 210. Then 2020, 2021, 216. And then last year I finished at 221. So that's basically where, that's my entire journey. So just because you average 140, 150 now, doesn't mean you're gonna average that forever. All right, so I'm gonna move back right because I think that's really where this ball shines a little bit. Oh, and I think if I was bowling a tournament, at least on a house shot here at Samstown, I think I'd bring this ball with me. Dude, it's like mixes everything. That's yeah, this is definitely the longest I've ever been able to play this straight here. Oh! All right, let's not miss left. Get this going nice and up the lane here. All right, last shot from out, and then I'll move back in, kind of slow hook it a little bit. I think another really big thing in your journey in bowling is bowl tournaments as early in your journey as possible on stuff other than house shots. And the reason I say that is because on a house shot, you have so much more room for error. You can make a lot of errant shots, and it'll trick your brain into thinking that you're a much better bowler than what you maybe actually are. So bowling on sports shots early in your development as a bowler is really gonna make you focus on shot making, execution, repeatability. Don't worry about what your rev rate is or what your ball roll is. Worry about execution and hitting your mark. All that stuff, the rev rate will come. My rev rate when I first started bowling in the first 10 years of me bowling was very, very low. So that'll come. When you look at guys like Norm Duke, whose rev rate is very low, especially in the grand scheme of things in the PBA, what makes him so much better than so many bowlers is the fact that he can repeat shots exactly the same way, time after time. And that ultimately will make your journey as a bowler so much better. So let's get all right, so like I said, I'm gonna move in here and really make sure I get the ball going right. Be nice and soft at the bottom. Oh, that's so funny. All right, let's try that again, but maybe not shoot it into the friction, just to see how it handles the oil. Much better, a lot of over under. All right, let's move right a little bit, but again, not send it into the friction to see. There we go. Yeah, so I mean, this isn't gonna be a ball that I'm gonna use all the time, but I think it has a very specific spot in my bag. When I can do that. I think on very high friction lanes, I think this could use some play. It mixes everything. All right, so we're on a nice little run here, so let's just keep it going. Yeah, the way that split the 8.9, that was pretty nice. Missed in. Nice. I really wish this string of strikes would have been all in one game. Last like 8 or 9 shots, I literally have not moved the board. All right, well, let's just keep going here. Nice and soft at the bottom. Don't want to overhit it. All right, guys, and then the biggest thing when starting your bowling journey, and this is gonna be super cliche, is as you advance and as you develop, remember the reasons why you're bowling. It's fun. Have fun. I know it's super cliche, and I'm guilty of this all the time, of not having fun when I'm bowling. Have fun. That is the most important thing. Thank you guys so much for joining me in this video. I hope you found this entertaining, informative, educational, whatever the case may be. Click right here to watch my other videos. Click right here to subscribe. Till next time.